year. I'm a software and construction engineering and management, and today I'm going to be talking to you a little bit about my summer internship with a company called SABC based out of Abuja, Nigeria. SABC is a residential company. It mainly specializes in the building of, you know, estates, houses, and, you know, just single-story houses as well. And over the past summer, I was based off two sites. The first site was a site where they were constructing a large estate called Teshi Estate down in one of the most rural areas of Abuja. And this estate had around, I think, 120 houses, and there were two main type of houses that were being built in that estate. The first type of house, as you can see on the right-hand side of the screen, was a two-story house which had around three bedrooms, and it had around two bathrooms as well. During the top floor and like in the bottom floor had around just one floor. And the second type of house that was being built was on the left-hand side of the screen, which is basically the same type of design, but it had two houses integrated into each other, so it was more like a duplex, and it had in total, I think, around six bedrooms, around three bathrooms. This was the second site where I was based in, and this was the site that I actually spent most of my time in. As you can see, on the right-hand side is a picture of the retaining wall while they were just finished demarcating everything. On the left-hand side is a picture of all the column bases they had finished demarcating as well. So I'd arrived pretty early, and I got to see really how, you know, how the phase went from concept design, conceptual design, to actually, you know, to the building stage itself. And I got to see that being applied as I got to see the superintendent and the field engineer working on all the column bases and demarcating them. And I even got to see them, you know, using different types of leveling instruments, such as, you know, chalk lines, which was really surprising for me at first, because I was used, you know, being based in the States, and some I was used seeing, you know, people serving with the T16 and instruments like that. So when I saw the chalk line, I was really surprised. But yeah, I got to see, you know, them really putting in the column bases, you know, using chalk lines to actually make sure they were aligned with all the specs, and using items such as the Jupiter rod, you know, to hold in the wood in place so that they can easily cast in all the columns as well for the column bases. This was a picture I took of the casting machine. It was my first time seeing it, so I was really surprised to see that big of a machine coming into a really tight site. And it was a really challenge for us because, you know, the column bases were fine, but when we got to the retaining wall, which was really, really far from the entrance gate, it got really hard, so we had to actually push everything back to make sure that the casting machine itself would be able to reach all the way backwards into the retaining wall. This was just a picture I took of the retaining wall being cast. You know, it had just finished putting all the column base at the bottom, and then we started casting it. But the main issue we had faced was in this picture. This picture, you know, as you can see in the bottom, you can see some water at the bottom of the retaining wall base itself. And this was a huge issue for us because, you know, it really delayed the construction, so we had to really take into consideration, you know, all the people that were supposed to come and work, and really change the whole schedule. And it really got to teach me how external factors can really affect, you know, your progress on the job site, so you really had to take into consideration everything. But overall, honestly, I would say it was a very good experience for me because it really broadened my scope, and it made me really see things that I would never have seen if I hadn't worked in an environment like that. And it made me really emphasize the importance of weather and external factors and how they can really affect your pace on the job site itself. I would really like to thank SABC for this opportunity and for such a